In the words of Ecclesiastes, a season is set for everything, a time for every experience under heaven, a time for laughing and a time for weeping, a time for speaking and a time for silence, a time for seeking and a time for losing, a time for giving birth and a time for dying. The time of mourning is a complicated time filled with many emotions and memories, both bitter and sweet. We begin our service with the recitation of psalms and prayers, thus linking Victor's life with the 3,000-year-old tradition of the people Israel and the eternity of God. Ашрей хаиш, ашер логалах бегатсат решаим, уведер хатаим логамад, увамошагав лецим лояшагав, киим беторат адонай хевцов, Ки йодеха Адонай дерех цадиким, ведерех решаим товет. Psalm number 15. O Lord, who shall dwell in your sanctuary? Who shall abide upon your holy mountain? He who lives with integrity, does what is right and speaks the truth in his heart, who has no slander upon his tongue, who does no evil to his fellow man, who does not reproach his neighbor. Whoever does these things shall stand firm forever. Mizmor le David Adonai ro'i lo echsar benodeshe yarbitzeini almei menuchot yenachaleini נפשי יושבי וינחני ומעגלי צדק למען שמו, גם כי אלך בגי צלמוות לא ירא רע, כי אתה עמדי. שבתך ומשענתך גם ינחמוני, תערוך לפני שולחן נגד צוררי, דשנת ושמן ראשי כוסי רוויה, אך טוב וחסד תרדפוני כל ימי חיי, ושבתי בבית אדוני לאורך ימים. 23rd Psalm, The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He has me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He guides me on path of righteousness. He revives my soul for the sake of his glory. Though I walk in the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no harm, for you are with me. Your staff and your rod comfort me. You set a table inside of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Дорогие Ира, Андрю, Дина, Джен, Люся, Женя, дорогие родственники и друзья, Мы собрались здесь сегодня по печальному событию, чтобы проводить в последний путь Виктора Ломоносова. Он прожил недолгую жизнь. Но подводя итог его жизни, мы можем сказать, что его жизнь была наполнена удивительными событиями. Он оставляет после себя так много. Он оставляет свое человеческое наследие и оставляет после себя свое математическое наследие, скажем так. Виктор Ломоносов был удивительным математиком, талантливым человеком, замечательным педагогом. Он уходит из жизни после тяжелой болезни, с которой он мужественно боролся, и которую он скрывал от своих друзей и даже близких, потому что не хотел никого обременять своими проблемами. Виктор был готов уйти из жизни. Он понимал, что его жизнь подходила к концу. И он хотел покоя для себя и покоя для своих близких. Он не хотел продолжать свои страдания и приносить страдания тем, кто был дорог ему. И я хочу, перед тем, как рассказать о его жизни, прочитать слова, которые написал еврейский мудрец по имени Бен Сира. Много столетий тому назад он сказал: «Не бойся смерти, нам всем суждено умереть. Мы разделяем это со всеми, кто когда-то жил, и со всеми, кто когда-то будет жить. Рыдай над умершим, не прячь свое горе, не сдерживай свой траур. Однако помни, что бесконечное горе хуже смерти. Когда умерший отправляется на покой, пусть его память успокаивается, и утешься, когда его душа отлетает. Смерть лучше, чем жизнь с болью, и вечный покой лучше, чем постоянная болезнь. Не старайся понять то, что недоступно тебе. Не ищи то, что спрятано от тебя. Не будь озадачен тем, что тебе невозможно понять. Как капля воды в море, как крупица песка на берегу, дни человеческой жизни вечности. Хорошее в жизни лимитировано днями и годами, однако доброе имя выдерживает приговор вечности». И как я уже сказал, Виктор оставляет после себя свое хорошее имя, имя, которое будет навечно написано в будущности. Виктор Ломоносов was born in Kharkov. His mother, Leah, was a teacher in a military college. She taught math and physics. Виктор didn't know his biological father. His uncle, Mark, became a father to him and played a major role in his upbringing. Lucy, you and Виктор were very close during your entire life. You were cousins, but in real life, you were like a brother and sister. You grew up together, and you stayed connected through all his life. Виктор graduated from high school in Kharkov and entered Moscow State University in a mechanical mathematics department. He was a very talented mathematician, almost on the border of being a genius. Later, Виктор solved the theorema that is named after him, the Ломоносов theorema. His name is mentioned in the Encyclopedia Britannica. After his graduation from the Moscow State University, Виктор worked in Moscow as a computer programmer. He wanted to have an academic career, but it was impossible in the former Soviet Union because of his Jewish identity. Mathematics was his life calling, and despite all the restrictions in the former Soviet Union, he continued to work in his field. Computer was his day job, but mathematics was his lifelong inspiration and passion. his theorema that is called after him, the Lomonosov theorema, became the basis of his PhD paper. Despite his success as a mathematician, he was a very modest man, and he never bragged about his achievement. He didn't want to waste his time to solving minor problems. He always tried to reach to the stars and worked on major problems in mathematics. Here, after his arrival to the United States, he solved the Klee problem that many mathematicians tried to solve for 40 years. Victor was a very charming man, and everybody loved him. He was a human magnet. People gravitated towards him. He was the life of a party, and everybody loved his stories and his jokes. Victor was a Renaissance man. He knew art, literature, poetry, different cultures. He possessed an encyclopedic knowledge. He was an avid reader. He loved sport, especially tennis and ping pong. He loved chess and skiing. In 1989, Victor emigrated from the Soviet Union. He came to Boston, and almost immediately he found his first job at Kent State University. Victor became a professor of mathematics at the university where he worked all these years. Ironically, that after arrival to the States, he received an international recognition and respect. People knew about him, but he was prohibited to travel from the former Soviet Union. And now, when he became free, figuratively and literally, Victor traveled the globe for his speaking engagements, and he didn't need an introduction, because the name Lomonosov was instantly recognizable. Family meant a lot to him. As I said, he grew up without knowing his biological father. And Victor loved his three children, and even though they all were born from different mothers, they were all equal to him, and he loved them equally. Irina, you and Victor met in 1995. You came to the States to work on your PhD at Kent State University. And first, you and Victor became a tennis partners. And after one year of competing on a court, you fell in love and you married. And you became like a team. You did everything together. You play tennis together, you ski together, you kayak together, you walk through the life together, you raise children together. Since he was a little boy, Victor loved outdoors. I'll switch to Russian now, sorry. Он очень любил ходить в походы, любил кататься на байдарках. Виктор очень любил природу. Ира, вы и Виктор купили дом в Авроре на озере, где он очень любил проводить время, любил ловить рыбу, любил кататься на байдарке по озеру. Виктор очень любил учить других тому, что он умел делать сам. Как я сказал, он от природы был педагогом. К сожалению, 6 лет тому назад у него обнаружили тяжелое заболевание. И, как я уже сказал, Виктор не хотел говорить никому о своей болезни. Его коллеги, друзья, никто не знал, что он был болен, никто не знал, насколько серьезно он был болен. Всю жизнь он всегда заботился о других, о своих близких прежде всего, и никогда не хотел обременять других своими проблемами. Поэтому он не хотел говорить людям о том, что он был серьезно болен, он не искал жалости от других. Никто из его друзей не знал о том, что он был действительно очень серьезно болен, и в течение 6 лет он боролся с этой болезнью. До самого конца. Вся его семья, все, кто был так близок ему, собрались вместе с ним в эти последние дни, чтобы попрощаться с ним. Виктор был готов к смерти, он не боялся смерти. Он хотел уйти, чтобы избавить себя и всех вас, своих близких, кто был очень дорог ему, кого он так любил, чтобы избавить вас от дальнейших страданий и мучений. Его друг Миша приехал из Калифорнии и попрощаться с ним и сумел прочитать молитву, которую евреи по традиции произносят перед смертью. Эта молитва называется «Ведуй короткое покаяние». И хотя Виктор и не был религиозным человеком, но удивительно, что в конце своей жизни судьбой он оказался связанным со своим Творцом. Согласно еврейской традиции и культуре, самое главное, что человек оставляет после себя, это свое хорошее, доброе имя. И Виктор Ломоносов оставляет после себя имя, которое сохранится в будущности. Тихи нишмато церура бицрора хаим, may his soul be bound up in the band of everlasting life. Пусть его душа навечно останется со всеми живущими. Я знаю, что кто-то из семьи хотел бы сказать несколько слов в память о Викторе. Пожалуйста, это вы решите сами, кто, так сказать, в каком порядке вы хотите выступить. Джен?
For those of you who don't know, I am his daughter, Jen. I am Victor's daughter, Jen. Victor, you were my father, my friend, my companion. You were always there for me with a hug, a pat on the head, corny jokes, and advice, even though I did not always listen. A funny story in which our lives intersected with his is my boyfriend Josh, 8 years ago, when Victor met him. Josh was coming to our house to meet my family for the very first time. He was walking up the driveway and Victor saw him, immediately said, no, no, thank you, we don't want anything. He thought Josh was a salesman. It was in the winter around the holidays, and he thought he was a salesperson or something like that. Victor, you are an unforgettable, absolutely unforgettable. We all loved you. We all miss you. I miss you so much. I am grateful for the time that I have spent together, the time that I have with you. I am eternally grateful for the chance to have walked this earth at the same time and place as you and everybody else as well. I love you, Victor.
Thank you.
Я всегда знала, что у меня есть старший брат, любимый старший брат. И Я всегда ощущала Витю как моего любимого старшего брата. Когда кто-то начинал задавать вопросы, тогда я объясняла: да, это мой двоюродный брат, но... И дальше следовали объяснения. Это было абсолютно неважно. Мы действительно росли вместе, и мой папа был ему как отец. Он заботился о нем. С тех пор, как он родился, с тех пор, как его из роддома его мама принесла домой. И это было всю жизнь. А потом, когда Витя вырос, он заботился о моем папе, о моей маме, которая тоже помогала его растить. Он заботился всегда обо мне, он заботился всегда о моих детях. Он нас всех очень любил. Я просто хотела это сказать.
Я не собиралась ничего говорить, но я все-таки хочу сказать, что Витя был не просто моим мужем, он был моим самым-самым лучшим другом. И мы действительно проводили очень много вместе времени, катались на лыжах, играли в теннис, и мы были очень competitive. I switched to English. For the last 6 years, when he got sick, of course, it was a very difficult time for both of us, but we grew even closer together, and we worked as a team, and I did my best trying to take care of him and help him as much as I could, and I know he appreciated it very, very much. The last few months were especially difficult, and I was only thinking about taking care of him, and I knew that he was terminally ill, and I understood already that he has just maybe a couple of months left, and like 2-3 weeks ago it was obvious that he has only a few more days left, and I didn't think about him leaving. I was thinking about only taking care of him, making him comfortable as much as I could. And even so, I knew that it was time for him to go. It is very, very painful that he left us. And some people say that it's easier when you prepare it for it, but it's never easy. Last 2 weeks, I knew it were especially hard for him. I knew it because I was with him all the time. And I understood that it was time for him to go, and I told him that I allow him to go. I told him that I will miss him very, very much, and it is painful not to have him with us. But I told him that I understand that he was in pain, and he was suffering, and his doctors tried to do everything possible, so he was not in pain, and helped him a lot. And I don't know, of course it's very, very hard time for me, and it will not be possible to adjust or forget him, and he will be always with me as a friend. And we decided to bury him at the Mount Olive Cemetery, which is in Solon, which is nearby from our house, and he knew about it, and he knows also that I like sports and I like to ride a bicycle, and I told him that I will visit him all the time riding my bike, and I will tell him about my timing, and he always was happy when I set up new records, and I will tell him all about it, and he will be happy, I hope. Okay, sorry, I did not prepare anything, and I'm sorry if I, okay, so, yeah. And I just also wanted to thank all of you for coming, and to all the friends. Some people just learned recently how sick Victor was, for your support. And some people were really involved and helped me a lot. Some people sent me emails and texts, and were ready to help anytime as soon as I called them. And I know that I can reach to any of you and get help, and it means a lot to me because it's really, really hard time for me and for our family. So Victor, I think, would be happy to see us all together and all remembering him and helping each other. And okay, thank you.
Thank you very much to all the members of the family for their moving and touching words. Please rise for the memorial prayer. Oh, we have one more. I'm sorry. Oh, okay. One more person. I'm sorry. Please sit down. Sorry, I didn't know that you were going to speak. Thank you.
Hello, dear friends. Well, Victor and I were neighbors for around 20 years. Neighbors in the sense that we were both at Kent State University in the mathematics department, and he was my next door neighbor in that his office was next to mine. And my office was the usual thing with filing cabinets and desks and chairs. And Victor had that as well as a sofa. And it was something that I used on occasion, and it was very often when he would visit me in my office, we would end up in his office because it was more comfortable. And what would we talk about? Well, we would talk about mathematics, but frankly, the research level was so different between us that it really, frankly, didn't, I mean, it hurts me to say in a way, but it didn't pay for Victor I could not really work with him and deal with him as an equal. He was so much stronger. What we would talk about, like we had a joint graduate student who finished, is now in Pennsylvania, and we would talk about, it was already mentioned, he just had an encyclopedic knowledge, and we would talk about things which classical music, and it was impressive, about politics, which we didn't always agree with, about especially Middle Eastern situations, which we didn't always agree. This time of year, the end of March, approaching April 15th, I would not be surprised to hear him knocking once or twice on my door with the Ohio 1040 return and a question about how to fill it out. And I did my best, and in a way, Victor was very, in a funny way, he was very frustrating that he knew so much in so many different ways. I remember once being very happy to share with him a joke I had heard, and I'll tell you the beginning, but no more than the very first sentence of the joke. And the very first sentence is that the man goes to his rabbi to say that somebody has stolen his bicycle. And the joke goes on and on. And Victor stops me and says, no, it's better with an umbrella. And for one thing, he was correct, but on the other thing, with such little information, how could he possibly know? But he did. So now let me really conclude with one, just a few very short paragraphs about what Victor elicited from people. This is from a very good friend and a very good mathematician in Spain, whom I did not even remember to contact, and who wrote to me late yesterday, actually very shortly after Ira had been in touch with Ira. So let me read just very, very briefly some things that he wrote. So, dear Richard, it's to me, and it's from somebody in Valencia called Vincent Montesinos. So, dear Richard, I do not know how to express my sorrow and to whom. I am ashamed that I didn't write to Victor in the last maybe 2 years, asking about him, sharing some words, some reflections, some jokes. In fact, I promised myself to do it, I just did not. I have, in fact, a very special feeling for Victor. This comes from my first visit to Kent, and it was renovated during the second stay and during the visit he paid to Valencia. I may not articulate it, but he was a spirit close to my appreciations. Despite the enormous mental distance and power between us, I still recognize the character I appreciated much, the wit, the sense of humor, the naturalness of his behavior. I'll always keep this feeling in me. Of course, the obituary speaks about how important a mathematician that he was, And this is something that everybody acknowledges. I cannot elaborate on this, but Victor occupied a place in my completely irrelevant life. In a sense, and despite the distance and the time, he made my life better. I'm proud to say that I knew Victor, not because I might add something to his life, but because he added something to mine. Thank you.
Okay, please rise now for the memorial prayer. Виктор бен Йосеф Велея, Шагалах Леголамо, Абаганадан Техай Менухато, Анабавал Рахамим, Астерай Обесетер Кнафех Леголамим. В эти цуроры, бецуроры, хаим это не шамато, а доганай гонахалато, в януах бы шалом алэ мишкаво, в эном арре амэйн. О, God exalted and full of compassion, grant perfect peace in your sheltering presence among the holy and pure to the soul of Victor Lomonosov, who has gone to his eternal home. Master of mercy, we ask you, remember all the worthy and righteous deeds that he performed in the land of the living. May his soul be bound up in the bond of life. The Lord is his portion. May he rest in peace, and we all say, Amen. Please be seated. Please remain in your seats until the casket will be taken out of the chapel. Pallbearers, please come forward. Пожалуйста, оставайтесь на своих местах до тех пор, пока гроб не вынесут из часовни. Те, кто будет